Air superiority plays a very important aspect of modern warfare. The party that rules the sky can dictate terms in the battlefield, which results in a massive advantage. The US has been at the forefront of using air power effectively in the battle space, having developed a wide array of advanced fighters, bombers, and supporting aircraft, and associated tactics for aerial engagement. But things are not going to be easy when it comes to imposing air superiority against near-peer rivals like Russia and China. One of the most potent challenges faced by the US is the advent of the highly sophisticated air defense system. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Valkyrie drones could be America's answer to Russian and Chinese air defense systems. Let's get started. Air defense systems have come a long way from their early humble origin. For example, let us take Russian S-400. The powerful main radar of S-400, which has a range of 600 kilometers, is complemented by target acquisition radars like 67N6 Gamma D and 9N6 Prativnik G radars in L-band, Nebo SVU in the very high frequency band, and Nebo M and Zebu M in multiband. Some of these radars, like Nebo SVU and Zebu M, have been claimed to have the ability to detect even stealth aircraft, like F-22 Raptor and F-35 Lightning II. S-400 deploys multiple missiles to cover its engagement envelope. 1. Short-range 9M96E, 40 km, with an active radar homing head, having the capability to intercept targets having a speed of up to Mach 2.6. 2. Medium range 9M96E2, 120 km, with an active radar homing head, having the capability to intercept targets up to a speed of Mach 3. 3. Long range 48N6, 250 km, with an active radar homing head, having the capability to intercept targets up to a speed of Mach 14. 4. Very long range 40N6, 400 kilometers, with an active radar homing head, having the capability to intercept targets up to a speed of Mach 14. Each S-400 battery consists of a number of transporter erector launchers, TELs, and each TEL has 4 launch tubes. In a standard configuration, a single battery has 4 TELs, but there could be up to 16 TELs per battery. So, depending on the number of TELs commanded by the S-400, it has 16 times 4, that's 64 missiles ready for launch at any moment. It's clear that an area defended by S-400 will be very hard to penetrate, and attempting to neutralize a battalion of S-400 could result in the loss of many aircraft and missiles, making it too expensive. But without air superiority, the American war machine will be in a much tighter spot and hinders its ability to wage a war on its own terms. This is where Valkyrie drone will come into the picture. The US Air Force has successfully completed the first ever test flight of its new stealth fighter drone, the XQ-58A Valkyrie. And on March 5th, the Valkyrie was launched from Yuma Proving Grounds in Arizona and flew for about 76 minutes. Viewers can check the link in the description to see the flight video. Valkyrie is developed by San Diego-based Kratos Unmanned Aerial Systems, who were given the contract by the Air Force Research Laboratory. The drone took about 2.5 years to complete. The project falls under the Air Force Research Laboratory's Low-Cost Attritable Aircraft Technology (LCAAT) program. The program is initiated to develop cheaper unmanned tactical aircraft. Valkyrie is conceptualized as part of the Loyal Wingman initiative, where it's supposed to fly alongside a manned aircraft and provide mission support. Valkyrie has a max speed of about 652 miles per hour. It can carry two small diameter bombs or compact electronic warfare equipment or surveillance systems. It can take off from a short runway like a plane or can be launched into the air via a rocket. Future variants could be developed for operation from aircraft carriers. Valkyrie has three aspects that make it a unique platform. 1. It's stealthy. 2. It has a long range of about 1,500 to 2,000 nautical miles. 3. It's pretty cheap at only $2 to $3 million apiece. This means that each drone costs the same as a single Patriot missile, which is not reusable. And around 30 of this can be bought for the price of an F-35, which costs around $100 million per aircraft. The cost factor looks even more promising if we consider that a stealth jet like F-35 needs massive maintenance cost. Valkyrie is compact in dimension, and being stealthy, it will be hard to detect and track. This will make it difficult for air defense systems to engage it. Since they're low cost, they can be deployed in large numbers to saturate air defense systems. A swarm of Valkyrie deployed with different payloads, like some with electronic warfare equipment and some with guided bombs, will be a complex challenge even for the best air defense systems. Even if most are intercepted during a strike, some will get through and knock off an air defense fortification. Valkyrie's range of 1,500 to 2,000 nautical miles makes it ideal for this kind of mission, since the launch platform can be outside the range of an air defense's strike envelope. In a battle scenario, it could be dedicatedly used to engage air defense, while stealth fighters like F-35 and F-22 take on enemy fighters. This will greatly reduce American losses, making it feasible to take on Russian and Chinese air defense.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.